Hello, hello. Welcome to the live stream. Happy Thursday, February 22nd. It is Christine with Gage Girl Training, online meal planning and coaching service. I hope everybody is well. And today we are talking about the number one factor that impacts female ability to lose weight. And I'm really excited to connect with you guys today. So I'm gonna give you guys a few moments to join the live stream. And while you are doing so, please say hello. Please comment where you're from. And please take 2 seconds to give the live stream a thumbs up. So I hope that 2024 has been treating you guys well. This year is going very, very fast. And guys, we're gonna blink and it's about to be March. So before I get into today's topic, hello, Rachel. I have one quick announcement, and that is the Winter Challenge will be starting on March 11th. And there are 2 days left, today and tomorrow, to get the discounted enrollment rate. The 6-week challenge is a macros-based challenge. You get custom macros that change every 2 weeks. You get custom workout for your macro type, home or gym-based, app-based. Oh, awesome, Rachel. And you guys can take advantage of the early enrollment discount for the basic enrollment. It comes with a weekly Zoom call. And on top of all of that, there is a huge discount on the one-on-one coaching upgrade. And that's only $499 for 6 weeks of coaching with me directly. I only have 2 spots left. So if you guys want to get in on that, please go to the website, gagegirltraining.com, to sign up. So I'm here today to talk to you guys about the number one factor that is impacting your ability to lose body fat as a female. And before I tell you guys what it is, I would love to hear if you guys have any guesses on what it might be. What is the number one thing that makes it more challenging for women to lose weight? And what is that one thing that's going to unlock a faster rate of fat loss? Does anyone have any guesses? Some people might say age, some people might say hormones, some people might say a wide variety of things. A lack of sleep, that is a very good answer. Any other guesses? Stress, ooh, very good one. Those are all very valid. They are all valid, but the number one thing that is impeding your ability to lose body fat is your muscle mass. Your muscle mass. And believe it or not, in a study in the Journal of Science from 2021, it stated that, and this is gonna really be shocking, your metabolic rate doesn't change all that much between 20 and 60. Now, after 60, you're going to be experiencing a drop in your metabolic rate by 0.7% per year, but you have to remember that muscle mass burns substantially more calories than fat. You need a circuit gym, you'll never go to the gym. And there is a lot you can do from home for those of you guys who don't get to the gym, don't have a gym nearby, or if you just don't feel comfortable. I have wonderful home training plans that can be done with minimal equipment with my challenges. And there is a challenge available for you guys to sign up for. But here's what I want you guys to understand. Muscle is metabolically active. It burns more calories than fat. And this is according to the American College of Sports Medicine. And the thing is, by age 50, if you are not consistent with weight training, you will have lost 10% of your total muscle mass. So dwindling muscle mass impacts the way you burn calories. And if you have never been a gym rat, if you've never been one of those folks who are just into weight training, even with that aside, you're still going to lose muscle mass with age. So the thing is, my friends, don't get me wrong, all exercise is good, but strength training, lifting weights, is the secret to building muscle. And it is so important. This is not just a thing for men. This is not just a man thing. And I know that a lot of women have a hesitancy to weight train. A lot of women think that if they start lifting weights, that they're gonna look bulky, that they're gonna look manly, and it is the complete opposite. What I need you guys to understand is that weight training impacts your muscle mass. Your muscle mass is metabolically active, and because your muscle mass is metabolically active, it's going to completely shift the way your body burns calories, And it's going to have a huge impact on how you look. So the first question I have for the group today is, how would you describe your relationship with weight training? Is it something you feel comfortable with? Is it something, Camille says, so funny, before hopping on this live, I was just thinking about increasing weight for the leg press so I can have bigger quads. You never increase it since 2 months now. And I strongly encourage you to increase your weights. Now remember, it doesn't have to be substantial. It just needs to be progressively overloading your muscles. How often do you have to do weight training each day? And does it have to be 80 or 70 pounds? Here's the thing. I recommend a minimum of 4 times a week. I have a free gift training plan available when you purchase my hormone reset protocol. It's a 12-week plan. And for my ladies who are dealing with hormone imbalances, and you don't want to burn out your adrenals, and you don't want to burn out your thyroid, and you don't want to overdo it, I totally get that. Four times a week is enough. It's more than enough. You don't have to be doing 5, 6, 7 days a week. You're welcome to do more if you wish. Three, it's not quite enough if you really want to see substantial changes. Three is fine for like maintaining, but I really need you guys to be aiming more in that 3 to 4 times a week range in order to make sure that you are going to see good results. And here's the thing, you guys, it's going to impact how you wear the weight, because it doesn't matter how much you weigh. And I know so many of us get so fixated on the number on the scale. We compare it to different stages in our life. And I think that as women, this is kind of crazy, but I guarantee you, every one of you guys watching here could probably tell me how much you weighed probably since you were a teenager at different stages of your life. I bet you guys could tell me how much you weighed when you were 16. You could probably tell me how much you weighed when you graduated high school. So most of you could probably tell me how much you weighed when you got married, when you had kids, or other major milestones in life. And we need to depart from the number on the scale, and we need to focus on, what is your muscle mass? How many pounds of muscle mass do you have? And how many of you guys attend a gym that offers an in-body scan? I'm not sure if you guys do, but most gyms these days do offer the in-body scan. It's a scale that you stand on. You have to like swab your feet. It's got special sensors that you hold on to. And the in-body scan will tell you your body fat percentage. It will tell you your muscle mass. It'll tell you your water percentage. It'll tell you a lot of interesting data that, if you guys have not got this done, I urge you all at your earliest convenience to get a benchmark of what your current muscle mass is today, this month, before the next month. It takes, oh my gosh, a minute, maybe 5 minutes all in to get it done. But it's a free service with most of you guys who have gym memberships. If you don't have a gym membership, I guarantee you could probably find some place that can do this relatively inexpensively. I know Orange Theory offers this as a service. I have a lot of clients who go to Orange Theory. But guys, please get this indexed, because you could be weighing the same but seeing substantial changes in the way you look because your body composition is changing. Somebody says here, as a mesomorph, I had experienced significant weight loss with reps of 4 times 10 to 15, 4 to 5 times a week. What rep range would I recommend? I recommend mixing it up. I like to do heavier days with lower reps and lighter days with higher reps. So I like to follow a push-pull legs split. And I was looking to see if I have a copy of my book here on my desk, and it's in the other room. But for those of you guys who don't know, I wrote a best-selling book, Unlock Your Macro Type. And in my book, Unlock Your Macro Type, I provide all of my strategies with regards to weight training for your body type. And I believe in a push-pull legs split. And there is a free workout plan in that program. It's a free 12-week protocol. And it is set up on 6 days a week. Now, you don't need to follow it 6 days a week, meaning if you can only go to the gym 3 days a week, 4 days a week, you just cycle through it as you can. And like I said, I like to do one round of my push-pull legs. meaning push is all the pushing movements, basically chest. Pull is basically back. Obviously, there's other things, and legs. Now, with that being said, what I like to do is I like to have a heavier day and a lighter day. So on the heavier days, I do fewer reps, more in that 6 to 8 rep range. And on the lighter days, I'll probably go anywhere from 15 to 20 reps. And I do them both within the same week, and I get fantastic results. And Sharon says, when I was 20 years old, I was around 260 pounds, and now you are 230. Well, it sounds like you've made progress, so congratulations on that. Deidre says, I was 160 pounds in college and wore a size 16. You're now 116 and you wear a size 8. Deidre, girl, that's incredible. If you are in my private Facebook group, your name looks familiar. I would love it if you could share a photo, because that's incredible. Girl, do you guys hear what she just said? She said she was 160 pounds in college, wore a size 16. She now weighs that now and wears a size 8. That's phenomenal. You should be very proud of yourself. And I really want you guys to embrace weight training and walking. I have found that what I used to do in my teens and 20s doesn't work for me anymore. I turned 42 this past January, and the magic formula that has been working for me, I'll be very honest with you guys, it has been weight training and it has been walking. I have never really been a huge fan of high intensity interval training. Do I have any folks who here who are big on HIIT? I know HIIT training and all the workout videos associated with it has been very trendy, it's been very intense. That stuff doesn't work for me, you guys. If I do a burpee, I feel like I'm going to pass out. And I know it sounds really weird. It's something about that jumping up and down that makes me really dizzy and nauseous. I despise burpees. I absolutely despise them. They make me sick, they make me dizzy. And what works for me and what I have been finding works better for my ladies, who I would say north of 35. And again, everyone's different, but I'd say north of 35, 40, you do so much better to just walk more and hit the weights consistently. And there's one thing I did want you guys to understand. Now, do I have any folks here who are over the age of 50? Do I have anyone here over 50? If you are over 50, I want to speak to you for 1 second. If you are not over 50, just log what I'm about to say. There's something called the 200 calorie rule. And the number of calories you need each day, it will drop slightly as you age, but most people will end up eating the same amount of food. It's pretty normal to think that you could just keep eating the same amount of food, but according to the government's dietary guidelines, advised that you would do best to burn approximately 200 calories fewer after age 50. So the best way to do that is to combine that with a little bit more activity and a little bit less food. And there was a landmark study that was published in 2017 in the Journal of Obesity, and they enlisted 249 people aged 60 or older to compare the effectiveness of diet and exercise on their fat and muscle. So the one group was asked to cut 300 calories a day from their diets, and the other group also did so, but they did about 45 minutes of aerobic exercise 4 times a week. And then the third group combined calorie cutting with weight training. And after those 18 months, the group who combined diet, a slight tweak in their diet, and the weight training, they lost the most weight, and that was 20 pounds on average. And the thing that you guys need to understand is that the group that did strength training lost more fat. So the quality of the weight that they lost was actually fat mass as opposed to losing just water weight or muscle mass. So the thing that I really want you guys to focus on is that you have to remember it's all about the quality of the weight you lose. It's not about the number on the scale. Who cares if you lose 20 pounds, but you lose 20 pounds of muscle? You're not going to look better. Does that make sense, my friends? And I mean that from the regard of your skin texture is not going to change. You're not going to have that tight, firm look. You're going to still have a lot of dimpling. You're not going to have that toned, athletic look. Again, I'm not saying we're going to look beastly, but I'm saying you're going to have a tightness to you when you have more muscle on your frame. And another thing that's super important is water. I talk about water all the time, my friends, and I feel like I'm beating a dead horse every time I tell you guys to drink more water, but your water directly impacts your liver. Your liver directly impacts your ability to metabolize fat. And the thing is, fat metabolism and fat oxidation occurs in the liver. And many people don't know this, but when you lose weight, the first place your body parts with stored fat, there's two places on your body that you lose it first. The first place on your body that you lose fat is the liver. The second place is the kidneys. So I know everyone might be so pressed, oh, I didn't lose weight yet. The weight is the same, Christine, this plan's not working, yada, 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 yada. Guys, you have to understand, give your body an opportunity to catch up. Your body loses weight from the liver first because that's where all that fat oxidation occurs. And if you are dehydrating yourself, you're not getting enough water. Guys, it's so easy to not drink enough water. Like, let's not act like we're all too cool. It's easy to do, but it's easy to forget. Does that make sense? It's easy to do, it's easy to forget. You guys, I have to fill this big ass jug every morning. I have water delivered to my house in those 5-gallon jugs. And if I don't fill this and like pay attention to where I'm at, I won't do it. Like, how many of you, and I mean this sincerely, you'll drink coffee all dang day, but yet you forget to drink water? Guys, please, for the love of God, and I mean this sincerely, I got this bottle from TJ Maxx. I think it was like $12.99, $15.99, something like that. And it was a godsend. I fill it up every day, and I don't care that I carry it around. I work from home. So guys, please, you have to understand that a lot of internal things need to occur in order for you to metabolize fat, but we need to be building muscle mass. We need to be carefully combining. We have to carefully combine that balance of weight training, caloric restriction, and making sure that you are getting the right amount of exercise with regards to cardio. I recommend walking. Jen says, I get tired of running to the bathroom every 15 minutes. Girl, so do I. But your body will adjust, your body will adapt. And the thing is, I don't know about you, I would rather not have headaches, not have migraines, not have congestion in my skin, and not having your urine stink. Not trying to sound TMI here, but when you don't drink enough water, guys, your urine stinks. And it's just very pungent, very concentrated. It's not healthy. You need to allow your body the opportunity to flush things out. Twisted Life says, I just turned 40, had a full hysterectomy 2 years ago, and your body is getting worse. No energy, added weight, HRT issues, any slow ways to start? The answer is yes. The answer is yes. I strongly encourage you to start with my hormone reset protocol. That protocol is a godsend. If any of you guys have done my hormone reset on here, it is like a hug to your body. It is nourishing. It allows your body to get the nutrients it needs to bring those hormones into balance, to number one, boost your metabolism. Number two, improve your cortisol. Number three, detoxify your body from excess circulating estrogens and hormones. Number four, it's going to help you bring your insulin levels into manage your insulin levels. And on top of that, it regulates your blood sugar and it really settles things down with the gut. And I say this because it is very effective. And for any of my folks here, do I have anyone here who's done the hormone reset? Excuse me. It's a wonderful plan. I do it a couple times a year. Do I think birth control prevents you from fat loss? 1000% yes. I have never had a client who came off of hormonal birth control, particularly estrogen-based, that did not see an improvement. I've never seen it. If you do not need to be on birth control for hormonal contraceptive purposes, you guys know what I'm saying. If you don't need to do so for contraception, please get off of it. Please get off of it now. I have to preface all of this. I am not a doctor, but birth control masks the symptoms and it does not allow your body to heal from the inside out. And hang on, friends, we're just dealing with a little bit of trolls. I am stopping birth control this week, but you also have PCOS. Absolutely. I have a lot of videos on PCOS, BBCon, and I actually dedicated a series of videos that I did in 2017 to PCOS. I have a client and friend and family member who was suffering from PCOS and was unable to conceive until she did my program. And I don't want to get emotional here because this person is my cousin. And I was by her side as she battled PCOS, battled multiple miscarriages, and we were able to heal her hormones with my hormone reset protocol. I was working with her side by side, and the principles that I established with her, this was over 7 years ago, laid the foundation of the hormone reset. So PCOS is manageable. You can still lose weight with PCOS, you can still naturally conceive with PCOS, and you can still have a very vital life. You can still feel really good. And I do strongly encourage you to look at the hormone reset plan. Now, if any of you watching this and you feel like your situation is different, but it's like somebody here said they had a partial hysterectomy, or if you just feel like you're on certain medications and you've had certain challenges and your situation is different than most, you would be a wonderful candidate for my one-on-one online coaching. It is the most affordable it has ever been in the history of Gage Girl training. You could sign up to work with me one-on-one for 6 weeks for only $499. You guys, my regular rate for that is over $2,500. It is a huge steal. There are two spots left, so I can only take so many people, but it is really heavy on my heart right now that there is somebody out here who's gonna come across this video who needs that TLC, who needs that personal attention, who needs to have things dialed in, who needs to be heard. What do I think about having a gut test? I think that there's nothing wrong with it. I think that there is a lot of benefits that you can gain from learning what foods do not agree with your body. I do think that it can also be navigated from trial and error as well, but you are welcome to get it tested. I think you're more than welcome to get it tested. It can only help, it can't hurt. But I don't find it 1,000% necessary, if that makes sense. All right, somebody here says, Marianne, I'm a mesomorph with Hashimoto's and strength, hit 1 hour cardio, yo-yo between 150 and 160, and I can see it. All TSH is optimal. Do you think it's water retention? No, I do not. I think you're doing too much, actually, Marianne. I would need to know more about your macros and how you're eating. But for my clients with Hashimoto's, less is more. Less is more. And I know people don't want to hear that, but the HIIT, the overdoing it with the training actually works against your body. I've never seen a case that hasn't been true. So you're going to need to learn how to dial that down a notch and not do too much, because a lot of times that can be overstressing your adrenals, that could be spiking your cortisol. And you have to remember, my friends, there's three hormones responsible for fat gain in women: insulin, the estrogen to progesterone ratio, and cortisol. Those three hormones, when they are not optimal, it's like, picture like a valve, it's like turning it off. It doesn't matter what you do, you can work out harder, 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 harder. Fat loss is turned off. You cannot lose more fat when those hormones are not optimal. Those hormones, those three hormones, again, when your insulin levels are off, when your estrogen and progesterone levels are off, and when your cortisol is off, when those three things are off, your body will not part with stored body fat. And if I had a nickel for every time somebody just said to me, oh, it's calories in, calories out, you're just not paying close enough attention to your macros. How many of you have ever heard that? How many of you have ever had a doctor, a trainer, or somebody mansplain it to you? I'm not trying to sound like a hater to men right now, but if you've ever had somebody try to tell you that you are not working hard enough And the reason why you're not losing weight is because you're eating too much, you're not paying close enough attention, and you're just doing too much. That infuriates me to the highest degree, because people do not have an understanding of how female hormones work. So do you need blood work done to check your hormones, or are there signs? You can absolutely do blood work. For blood work, you want to do so during days 19 to 21 of your cycle, with day one being the day that your period starts. But I feel that observing of whether or not you have the signs of hormone imbalance is a much better gauge. And the reason why I say this is because I believe that female intuition is very real. As a woman, we know when something's wrong with our body. How many of you guys believe in female intuition? And I mean this sincerely. I'm not trying to sound like hocus pocus. If you don't get a cycle, you can test your hormones at any point, Danae. But how many of you guys believe in female intuition, that you can intuitively feel and know when something's off? You make your wife take iron supplements. That's a good start. But there are other markers that you want to have her pay attention to. You want her to pay attention to her omega-3s, her vitamin D, her magnesium, and her fiber. Those are really important things. So I'm going to share with you guys really quickly the 20 signs of imbalanced hormones. If you deal with five or more of what I'm about to share, you most likely have a hormone imbalance. And I hate to say this, but it doesn't take a rocket scientist to know when something's off with your body. You guys know what I mean. That female intuition is so crucial. It's right like 99.9% of the time. You know as a woman when something's off. You know as a woman when something is off with your body. And the thing to add insult to injury is when someone tries to convince you that you're crazy, when someone tries to convince you that you're not working hard enough, when someone tries to convince you that you're eating too much. So with that being said, you guys, here we go with regards to the signs of imbalanced hormones in women. We're talking about bleeding in between periods. We're talking about hair loss. Now, when I say hair loss, I know a lot of us lose hair in the shower, but I'm talking like specifically here in your temples. If you find like it's starting to thin here, if you find that the outer parts of your eyebrows just no longer grow, if you start to get a bald spot right here in the middle of your head, numbness and tingling in your hands, fatigue. Now, when I say fatigue, my friends, I mean fatigue in a very serious manner. I'm talking about the type of tired that sleep doesn't fix. Do you guys know what I mean? Meaning if you feel like you need to drink coffee all day, or you cannot power through the day without more caffeine, or no matter how much you sleep, no matter how much you rest, you're still just dragging ass. You guys know what I'm talking about? Fatigue is real. And yes, it can be related to stress. Yes, it can be related to stuff that's going on in your life. But nonetheless, the impact of your body when you're feeling fatigued and you just are dragging, that's a sign. That's a sign of a hormone imbalance. The next one is pelvic pain. If you're ever just feeling like just strange, like nudges and tweaks when you stand, when you sit, if something feels off with your pelvis, cold hands and feet, that's another one. Skin tags. So obviously you guys know what skin tags look like. Unusually having menstrual bleeding, darkened skin, specifically the neck. If you start finding you're getting like darker pigmentation in the neck, in the armpits, or in the groin. Stalled weight loss. Irregular periods, intolerable PMS. Have any of you guys ever had PMS so bad that ibuprofen just wasn't enough? Do you guys know what I'm talking about? Where like it was so bad you wanted to call off work, you felt like you needed to lay in bed all day. Maybe you've even been laying there in actual tears. If you have experienced actual tears where you felt like you were actually crazy, and like I almost want to cry saying that, because I have had clients who have literally been, and it upsets me so much because I've dealt with this too. Have you ever literally laid down on the bathroom floor in pain, crawling in pain due to your period just being so god awful that you just, the only time when I'm off with my body is between my periods because you get hungry. Stress. Now, again, when I say stress, I'm not talking about the generic label of stress. Everybody's stressed. Everybody's overwhelmed. Everyone's got stuff going on in their life. But I'm talking about the type of stress that gives you a physiological response. Have you ever been so stressed out that you feel like a tightness in your chest, or you feel like you can't breathe, or maybe like your neck, it feels like you swallowed something so big, or maybe it's like a feeling that you have in your gut, or like when you are experiencing that physiological response to stress, maybe it feels like you are like white knuckling it, and the most basic tasks are so hard for you. Things that you should be able to do, like, I don't know, your laundry, cooking dinner, washing dishes, just doing, writing emails. If it feels so much harder to do that due to stress, that's a sign. That is a sign. Again, I said fatigue. I said it already, but I'm going to say it again. Fatigue is a big one. No matter how much you sleep, you are just drained and tired and you're off. Low libido. There's that. Hot flashes. Conflicting results. Have you ever felt so off? Your doctor runs some tests and they say nothing's wrong with you, just lose weight. The countless number of clients who have come to me in tears, having been medically gaslit by their doctors, by their primary care physicians, telling them, just lose weight. Just lose weight. It has to be one of the most insulting things that I think that you could say to somebody, because I think that if it were that simple, most people would have done that by now. Does that make sense? And if you are having an extra layer of complication, you have to remember, my friends, doctors are in the business of prescribing prescription medication. They're not going to recommend the right nutrients you need to feel more energized, to have a healthy libido, to be able to lose weight and feel more vital and just feel normal and energized. They're trying to band-aid symptoms. They're not trying to cure you from the root. And food is your best medicine. Hands down, without a doubt, my friends, food is your best medicine. And I cannot advocate enough for how much that you can change your life by properly understanding the food your body needs to heal. Sharon says, I don't want to lay down when I have my period because it feels like a bag of weight on me and I can't get up. And girl, that feeling you feel is very, very real. Liver problems like cirrhosis, even if you don't drink or eat excessive fat. And I have to tell you guys something about the liver and alcohol. Now, if I know I have some ladies here over 50. And did you guys know that, I'd say it might even be younger than 50, when we feel stressed out, when we feel overwhelmed and we have all of those things, does anybody here, please keep it real, you guys, this is a judgment-free zone. Does anyone here ever feel like turning to alcohol when you're stressed? I'll be very honest with you guys, every now and then, when you're overwhelmed sometimes, that glass of wine, for me, my drink of choice is, I love dirty martinis. I love dirty martinis and I like skinny margaritas. And there is a study that shows, and I'd be happy to share it with you guys, that when your hormones are imbalanced as a female, now this applies to women only, you actually experience a higher dopamine rush with alcohol consumption over 40 with women when your hormones are imbalanced. Now think about that for a minute. What does that mean? When your hormones are imbalanced, your body experiences a higher dopamine level, which means you literally experience more pleasure from alcohol when your hormones are imbalanced. How freaking crazy is that? Which in turn starts a negative cycle, because the higher dopamine that you experience with drinking alcohol, what's going to happen? The more you're going to want to drink alcohol to manage that stress. It is a very vicious cycle. And there is not enough data, there is not enough people speaking to the fact that these things are real, that these things are plaguing women. And if you ever like low-key feel bad that you want a drink, like does anyone here ever like feel like a little bit of guilt being like, dang, I probably shouldn't be having this drink, but man, it's chilling me out. Well, if it's chilling you out, that feeling is real. On a biochemical level, your body experiences a dopamine increase substantially higher than what other people were, what other people would experience. So I'm saying this to you guys is that the stress you are feeling is real. If you are feeling relaxed from alcohol, that is very real, but it is vicious. It's kind of like the whole thing when you're craving sugar, when you have insulin resistance, your body wants more sugar, but your body doesn't need more sugar. Your body is intrinsically trying to ask for more alcohol because it wants that dopamine rush to get out of that state of being chronically stressed, but that's not what your body needs. So it's a lot for women to navigate all of this. Hot flashes, conflicting results, extreme mood swings. Whew, let's talk about mood swings for a second. Have you ever felt out of your mind when your hormones are off? Meaning, I'm just gonna say it, my friends. I'm just gonna say it. Have you ever felt out of your mind bitchy? Like you're so bitchy, you can't stand to be in your own skin. Everything irritates you. Everything annoys you. Your patience is like so thin. Things that you would normally be able to handle and deal with, you just can't. Like you just have this, I give up, and it is very, very hard for you to navigate just basic things in life because your moods are all over the place. Maybe you find yourself getting into arguments with your significant other, maybe with your kids. Maybe you find yourself just internally struggling with a lot of mood swings that make it very painful and unbearable, and again, make you feeling like you want to drink. And then last but not least, an inability to lose weight no matter how hard you try. If any of that sounds like you, my friends, it's most likely an imbalance in your hormones. And I want you guys to focus on increasing the nutrients that you are obtaining from food. I want you to focus on improving the nutrients you are obtaining from food. I want you guys to start paying attention to your vitamin D levels, to your magnesium levels, to your omega-3 fatty acids. Now remember, omega-6 is the bad kind, omega-3 is the good kind. Your fiber and your magnesium, those are going to be very, very crucial. So back to what we were saying about the imbalanced hormones, staying properly hydrated is going to be so important because it is going to allow your body to detoxify excess circulating estrogens that occurs in the liver. Now, the next thing I want you guys to do is you really want to pay attention to any medication that is hormone-based, steroid-based, and specific antidepressants. Now, if any of you are curious or you want me to review if any medications that you are taking, again, guys, I'm not a medical doctor, so you have to understand I'm not a medical doctor, but what I can do is I can explain the impact that certain things have on weight loss. And that is my expertise. My expertise is fat loss, weight loss. And I have the scientific knowledge and backing to understand how medication impacts your ability to lose fat, how hormones impact your ability to lose fat. Because at the end of the day, guys, you want to look the way you want to look. You want to feel the way you want to feel. And I know that so many of you guys feel trapped. I know that there's some of you guys watching this right now that feel like giving up. I know that there are some of you guys right now that you don't feel like yourself. You haven't felt like yourself in a long time. How many of you guys have clothes in your closet that don't fit you? And you're not throwing them out, you're not donating them because you really want to be able to fit in them again, but you don't feel comfortable in your skin. You just don't. You feel tired, you feel sluggish, and you feel defeated. What I'm here to tell you is that for every challenge, there is a solution, but the solution that you may be utilizing to approach this may be substantially different than what you've done in the past. And if nothing changes, nothing changes. Meaning, if you keep doing the same thing over and over and over and over and over again, and you're getting the same exact results, that is the definition of insanity. That's insanity. And how many of you guys watching this are like, Christine, I'm at my wit's end. I don't feel good. I don't feel comfortable naked. You don't want to weigh yourself, but you know deep down you want to feel better. You know that you can do better. And you're lost and you don't know where to start. If this is you, I do invite you to sign up for one of the two spots I have left for my one-on-one online coaching promotion. It is a huge discount. It is only $499 to work with me for 6 weeks. You will be working with me personally. We will do Zoom calls. If you don't want to do Zoom, you don't feel comfortable on camera, we can do on the phone. We review everything. I go in depth. We review everything on a weekly basis. Your progress photos, your measurements, how your week went. I hold you accountable. And guys, there's nothing wrong with needing TLC. There's nothing wrong with investing in your health. There's nothing wrong with needing support. And I think too many of you guys, you try to do it on your own. You try to Google all of the solutions. And if you're not ready for that and that's not within your budget, I completely understand. You can do the challenge for $89. That introductory rate expires Friday. After Friday, it goes up to $129. Or you guys can get started on my hormone reset. It's a great plan. I have wonderful supplements that will help you facilitate this. But end of the day, I want you guys to focus on increasing your weight training. I want you guys to get comfortable with weights. Now, how many of you guys work out from home or gym? Can you please comment whether or not you work out from the home or if you work out in the gym? And if you are just joining, is it good to take vitamin D3? Yes, it is. It is very good to do so. And if you're just joining and you've been listening and enjoying my lives, I'm going to ask you guys two things. Hit that thumbs up button. Please hit that thumbs up. I believe you have to hit the three dots. You have to hit the three dots to do it. So please take 2 seconds. You do gymnastics. Is that a sport? That is absolutely a sport. Okay, great. We have a handful of ladies, Yadira, Jacqueline, Bibi in the gym. If you are not in the gym or you do a hybrid of home and gym, I'm asking you guys to seriously make weight training a priority. Muscle is metabolically active and it changes the way you metabolize and burn body fat. And it is hands down one of the most important things you can do in addition to dialing in your nutrition. Now, dialing in your nutrition does not always mean eating less. I just got off the call with one of my one-on-one online coaching clients a couple hours ago, and she had a breakthrough this past week. She lost 4 pounds in this last 7 days. And I reran her numbers, double checked everything. I have her on 1850. You guys, check this out, guys. I have her on 1850 calories. And she lost 4 pounds last week. I ran the math. I saw where she needed to be. And guess what the math said? I actually changed her macros this week to over 2000 calories. And she's still making progress. So my point is, knowing what to do, knowing where to set your calories, knowing when you should shift to more fat, to less carbs, to more protein, it matters. There's a science to it. And guys, I've worked with over 50,000 clients, so I'm not coming to you as somebody who just had my own physical transformation, because you can find people online who look amazing. It's not hard to find a good-looking fit chick in 2024 on the internet. Good-looking people are everywhere you go. Some of their bodies are fake, some of it's genetic, some of it's whatever. Just because you look good does not mean you are qualified to navigate somebody's specific personal situation. Doesn't mean you know how to change your calories, adjust their macros, adjust their strategies. There's strategies to this, you guys, and it's so much, it's meal timing. It's should you intermittent fast? It's what should we fuel you with before your workout, after your workout? How should we stage your rest days? There's a wide variety of factors that come into play that 90% of coaches out there will miss. 90% of coaches out there will miss. And I say this with full confidence because I have worked with the folks who've worked with all of the Instagram celebrities and are getting nowhere. So I really want you guys to experience progress. And not only physically, guys, but you have to remember this has to be a lifestyle change. And so many of you guys have given up on yourself. Some of you guys get defeated. And that extra encouragement, that extra boost, having someone believe in you, having someone tell you, say, you know what, you can do this. Don't give up. Do you know how crucial that is to hear that? Because I guarantee you, you're not getting that at home. Most people in your immediate circle might be like, ah, why do you got to do all that? Ah, just go on Ozempic. Oh, just get a tummy tuck. Oh, just do this. Or some people might tell you, you look fine. But the thing is, to most people, you might look fine. But to you, you don't feel good. You don't feel yourself. And how many of you guys have ever been told, why you got to do all that? Those people don't understand your goals, nor are they going to understand your goals. And that's fine. Not everybody is going to get it. Not everyone's going to get it. And it's unrealistic to expect people to get it. Does that make sense? Your husband, your partner, your significant other, whoever's closest to you may not get it. And that's okay. How many of you guys watching this right now feel like the person closest to you just doesn't understand your plight? They don't understand how much harder it is for you. And sometimes you start to doubt yourself and ask yourself, am I weak? Am I lazy? Like, why is this harder for me? I'm gonna tell you why it's harder for you. The way you're currently eating, and there's the way you need to be eating. There's a gap with nutrients, and it can be quantified. I'm being very serious right now. There is a gap, and you need to align what your body needs with what you're fueling yourself with, because how many of you guys could look at yourself and look at your body and look at your energy and look at your nutrients and look at your macros and look at your micros and say, oh, I'm short on my magnesium. Oh, I'm off by this percent of fiber. Oh, I'm off by my vitamin D. Like, you can't. Does that make sense? You can't. And what I want you guys to focus on instead is identifying those nutrient gaps, closing those gaps, because when you eat the way your body needs, and that's in alignment, that's the goal. And it's the most exciting thing ever when your body gets what it needs. When your needs are met, you feel amazing. It's just like relationships. When your needs are not being met in a relationship, when you need X, when you, let's say you need validation, let's say you need to be told certain things, let's say maybe you need touch, maybe you need to be hugged. If those needs are not being met, you're not gonna feel good. Versus when you are being validated and you are being hugged and you are being loved on. Again, it's an analogy, but my point is we can easily understand why you're not going to feel right when your needs are not being met. And I want you guys to understand is that you need to become the expert of your own body. You have to become the expert of your own body. You have to do your own research. And I've always prided myself on providing you guys a lot of educational information. And the reason for this is because my clients are pretty sharp folks, if that makes sense. Meaning, my clients are educated. You guys most likely read labels. You guys most likely are pretty woke in the sense that you do your research. you don't take big pharma and big food and the FDA at face value. You are the type of person that reads between the lines. You are the type of person that does your research. You're the type of person that makes an educated decision. And if that's you, you're in the right place. Like, my content's perfect for you because I'm gonna tell you all that nuance. I'm going to explain to you all of those things. So my friends, it's been a pleasure connecting with you today. Thank you for joining this live stream. I love you guys, and I'm always thankful for the opportunity to chat with you. Last thing before I sign off is I'm going to ask you guys to make sure you subscribe to the channel. Please, before you sign off, just hit that thumbs up. Hit that thumbs up because it helps your girl out here on YouTube. Even if you never buy a product from me ever in your life, if you could just like and comment on my videos, guys, it really blesses me and helps me out a lot. But last reminder, the early enrollment discount for the next challenge, which starts March 11th, it ends tomorrow. So the basic entry is $89, custom macros, workouts, weekly Zoom calls, all the things, and the coaching promo, you guys. I got two spots left, and I'm looking for two people that are ready to be poured into. I'm looking for two people who need that TLC, like that TLC that you know you're lacking from your doctor, you're lacking from your trainer, you're lacking from your OBGYN, and you're ready to heal your body. So friends, I love you all. Thank you for being here today. Head on over to gaugegirltraining.com, G-A-U-G-E. I'm sorry for that chewing. I have two puppies here in my home office. So have an amazing day. Love you all. Peace out.